Bronwyn Kathleen Bishop, Australian Parliament's answer to Cruella de Vil, has finally had her fabulous light snuffed out.
After 22 years as the member for McKellar, Tony Abbott's mum has passed on to her next life.
Well-paid Conservative speaking to us.
Yes, the daughter of an opera singer has finally heard the fat lady sing, or in this case, the fat millionaire.
Bronwyn, goodbye, bye, bye.
In 1987, Bye Bye Bronnie became the first female elected to the New South Wales Senate after heavily influencing today's most successful Destiny's Child.
Bronnie.
Quickly proving herself to be an aggressive debater, Bishop made her way to shadow ministry in less than 2 years. She was beloved by all, with former Foreign Minister Gareth Evans once exclaiming,
"Why do so many people take an instant dislike to Senator Bishop? It saves time."
Since then, she went on to become Shadow Health Minister, where, on her first day, she announced her support for the tobacco industry.
I am in flavor country.
You, sir, are worse than Hitler.
Unsurprisingly, like a Catholic priest, she was moved to a new parish, portfolio. Finally, when Howard brought the Libs back into power, Bishop spent several days bathing the elderly in kerosene.
Just to clarify, she didn't actually bathe them in kerosene. There was nurses, there was a retirement home in Melbourne, but she was the aged care minister and she didn't pick it up. So it was a whole thing. Anyways, she got kicked to the backbench.
For many sad years, Australia waited for her comeback. When eventually newly minted Prime Minister Tony Abbott, the self-described love child of Howard and Bishop...
Wait, I'm okay.
Put Mummy Dearest in the speakership. Bronwyn, she thrived in the role, breaking records left and, well, mostly left. In one single day, she booted 18 Labor MPs from question time.
The member for Greenway will leave. The member for Hotham will leave. The members for Batman will leave. You may leave. The member for Shorten will leave.
And in her 1 year and 9 months as a completely non-partisan speaker, she ejected MPs a total of 400 times, seven of which were Liberals. But the thing our fancy lady will be remembered for most is her expensive taste. $5,000 helicopter rides, $88,000 worth of trips to Europe, and in 2014 alone, $800,000 worth of work expenses, all charged to you, the taxpayer.
One doesn't resign for an error of judgment when it's within the guidelines.
But one did. Bowing to political pressure and moving back to the backbench, she thought she'd left behind for good.
A fighter to the last, Bronwyn refused to leave Parliament, citing her long fight against terrorism. Bronwyn, Australia, and the many helicopter pilots of Australia, we will miss your sense of entitlement.